Alright, so in the anterior quadrant, we assess the anterior recess of the tibiotalar joint. We assess the anterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, the anterior talofibular ligament, the calcaneofibular ligament, the extensor tendons, and the dorsal metatarsal ligaments. Anterior recess of the tibiotalar joint is easily assessed by routine ultrasound techniques. Whereas the posterior joint recess may be a little bit difficult to assess unless the joint is really distended by a lot of fluid. The subtalar joint space may communicate with the tibiotalar joint space in approximately 10% of the patients. So we start scanning the anterior joint recess in the long axis by identifying the tibia, the talar dome, and the talar neck. And just above the talar dome, what we see is a hypoechoic cartilage of the talar dome. And just anterior to that, you have an intra-articular but extra-synovial fat pad. So when we screen from medial to lateral, we look for joint effusion in the long axis. So this is the patient wherein on the left side, this is the normal ankle joint where we see the tibia, the talus, and the anterior fat pad. Whereas on the right side, we see that the effusion has caused the anterior fat pad to be displaced anteriorly. Coming to the anterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, this ligament is actually a syndesmotic ligament which spans the tibia and the fibula. I would encourage you to look at the fibers, you know, the orientation of the fibers of the anterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, so that when we want to scan the AITFL, we identify the fibula and the tibia and we put our probe obliquely in the direction of the fibers. Hence, we see the AITFL as an echogenic structure with multiple linear striations. The anterior talofibular ligament is the most commonly injured ligament in inversion injuries of the ankle. Hence, this is one of the most common indications for ultrasound assessment of the ankle joint to see the integrity of the ATFL. Now, if we look over here on this gross anatomy dissection, we see that the ligament spans the lateral malleolus and it goes all the way across to the talar neck. And if you see, the orientation of the ligament is almost parallel that to the plantar surface of the foot. So we assess the ATFL by putting the plantar surface of the foot on the over the bed, flat on the bed, and we connect the two bony prominences. This is the lateral malleolus and that's the talus, and this is what we see over here. That is the anterior talofibular ligament, which is seen as a nice echogenic structure, multiple striations, and you see a little bit of fluid in the lateral gutter. This little triangular space is known as the lateral gutter, which is a part of the anterior joint recess. The calcaneofibular ligament is located between the calcaneum and the fibula. The fibular attachment may be slightly difficult to assess. However, when you do a forced dorsiflexion, you will be able to see the entire calcaneofibular ligament really well. And so during dorsiflexion, you cause the ligament becomes taut and you see the peroneal tendons, which over here, they are seen much more better. So this is a ligament which would require a little bit of dynamic maneuvering, and this ligament can be easily assessed on the long axis. Coming to the extensor tendons are typically your tibialis anterior, your extensor hallucis longus, and your extensor digitorum longus tendons. So the pathologies of extensor tendons are very few, but they're commonly injured, you know, and they may get injured when there is a sharp injury and they may result in complete tearing of the tendon. The extensor hallucis longus is the most commonly torn tendon that we see. From medial to lateral, we see the tibialis anterior, the extensor hallucis longus, the tibialis anterior artery, the nerve, and the extensor digitorum longus as the lateral most tendon. The superior and inferior extensor retinaculi are located at these levels, and the tendon sheaths are located at the levels of the inferior extensor retinaculi. On the long axis, the tibialis anterior, the extensor hallucis longus, and the extensor digitorum longus are seen as a typical fibrillary pattern with a collagen bundles crossing through, and disruption of these bundles should be suspected when there is a tear or tendinosis. And coming to the dorsal and metatarsal ligaments, we are typically talking about the dorsal talonavicular, the bifurcate ligament, and the calcaneocuboid ligament. Now, these ligaments can be easily injured in high-grade inversion injuries, and these are commonly missed on routine imaging, such as the radiographs. Hence, when the patient comes for assessment of inversion injuries, these ligaments should also be scanned to rule out any obvious ligament injury. So this is how it looks on the gross appearance. So this structure, which has been labeled as 12, that is the dorsal talonavicular ligament. The structure which has been labeled over here, just anterior to the anterosuperior process of the calcaneum, that's your bifurcate ligament. And the structure, the lateral most, is a calcaneocuboid ligament. So dorsal talonavicular ligament, we connect the navicular and the talus, and we see this nice ligament over here, very superficial structure. Similar case with the bifurcate ligament, we identify the anterosuperior process of the calcaneum, and the ligament is seen as a echogenic cord-like structure. And similar appearance of the calcaneocuboid ligament by connecting the cuboid and the calcaneum.